Hello students and welcome back to the video lecture series of software engineering. Today's topic is user interface design. I am your instructor Ms. Shruti Rawal. So let us study what are the golden rules for user interface design. So basically there are three golden rules for user interface design that we will study, and that actually depicts that what do you mean by good designing and what do you mean by bad designing. Because user interface is the last phase of designing where actually the user interacts with your system, right? So there is a human computer interaction involved in user interface design. So it is very necessary that the interface that you design for user is basically aesthetically good, so that there is a quality in your user interface, right? So let us study what are the golden rules. The first rule for user interface design is place user in control. Now what do you mean by place user in control? It means that if user is interacting with your system, user wants that he or she should control the computer and not computer should control him, right? So everything on the website or your web application page must be in control of the user. Now let us study some of the points inside this place user in control. The first is that you have to define the interaction modes in a way that it does not force a user into unnecessary or undesired action. So for example, let us see an example. Here you can see that if you want something to be in an editable mode, the best way is to click, or you can say double click on that particular component or element, and that component coming directly into the edit mode so that the user can edit it easily, right? So here you can see first the component is in yellow color. When the user is clicking it, it converts its color into white color so that user gets an idea that now it is in editable mode. As soon as the user is escaping, that is he or she is pressing escape in the keyboard or clicking outside that particular element, that user should be from editable mode, he should go to non-editable mode, right? So this is the basic thing that should be included in a user interface, so that the interaction with the user interface does not force the user into unnecessary action like here it is shown, right? So if you compulsory tell the user to perform unnecessary actions for going into the edit mode, here you can see there are action 1, action 2, action 3, action 4, then the user is performing sub actions and then he or she is going into the edit mode. That is very confusing and that is very not user friendly. So these type of editing mode is not recommended. Similarly, all the interaction on your user interface should be such that no unnecessary actions should be required, right? The next point is that you should provide flexible interaction. What do you mean by flexible interaction? Every user has his or her own preferences for interacting with the user components that you have placed in your website or web application, right? For example, some users are comfortable by using the keyboard, whereas others are comfortable using the pen, others are comfortable using mouse, right? So you should provide a mechanism in which all the users, irrespective of the preferences, can deal or they can interact with the user interface components, right? Also, you must take into consideration, like for example, if you have a user interface in which there is some sort of drawing involved, then instead of the keyboard inputs, your user may be comfortable using a mouse, because it is very simple to draw something using a mouse rather than a keyboard, right? So you must provide flexible interaction modes while you are designing a web page. The next thing is that you have to allow user interaction to be interruptible and undoable. It means once user has performed some action, it should be necessary that the user can undo its action, right? If you are forcing the user to do something and not undoable, then the user may get frustrated, right? For example, if the user is drawing something or user is processing something and you are not allowing the user to undo it, and if he or she has committed some error or he or she has not interacted with a way that he wants, then what will happen? Yes, the user will get frustrated because the thing is not interruptible or it is not undoable. So instead of this, you should make the user interface in such a way that user, whatever the progress of your user interface is, the user must be able to interrupt and undo the previous action, right? The next point is that you have to streamline your interaction as the skill level increases, right? Because all the users may not be educated, they must not have equal skill levels in your web application, right? So you must streamline all the skill levels. You have to take into consideration what are your targeted users and what is the skill of that user, right? So for example, here you can see the normal things are return first, that is copy, paste, cut, that are the normal operations that all of them can perform. Now there are some highly, you can say a little bit on the higher side interaction like toggle item or options that you have put in the next phase, right? So you have to make your user interface in such a way that your interaction, that is user's interaction, advances you can say in a hierarchical manner, right? The next point is you have to hide technical internals from the casual users, right? For example, if the user is prompted to enter an email ID and if he or she is entering wrong email ID, you can see the alert, the first alert, this is very wrong. Email does not pass the regular expression. What does it mean? The casual user is not aware about what do you mean by a regex, right? Because he or she is a novice user or he or she is a non-technical user. So what do you mean by regex? He or she is not aware about. So instead of that, you have to write a normal English in which you can say that please enter a valid email format, and you can just give a format which is valid as an example, right? So that is a better method instead of displaying the technicalities or technical internals to the casual user. You can skip that altogether, right? Now the next point is you have to design for direct interaction with objects that appear on the screen, right? So for example, you can see that there are some objects like you can see this is a toggle object, this is a rectangle object. Now you have to design your user interface in such a way that users can directly interact with them, right? For example, if there is a rectangle over here and if that shape is editable, the user should directly click on the rectangle's edge and may be able to stretch it. Also, the user may be able to click on this toggle button and it should be toggled, right? So direct mechanism with the user interface objects should be permitted. That will be a better way to design your user interface so that the manipulation is easier, right? Okay, the next golden rule is you have to reduce users' memory load. Now, we don't want that once user is entering your web application, he or she has to use so much of memory that they are immediately skipping to see whole your website or web application, right? We have to make sure that there is minimum load on user's memory. And for that, there are number of techniques or number of user interface rules that we have to follow. Let us see what are they. The first thing that you can do is you have to reduce the demand on short-term memory. Now, there may be some cases, for example, here you are telling the user to pick a favorite movie, right? So here, the first design is giving some of the suggestions of the movie and directly from the suggestions they can pick, right? Instead of that, what is happening over here, you are just giving a search box or a text box and you are forcing the user to enter your movie name, right? And it is not giving suggestion at all. So that means that you are forcing the viewer to remember all the movies that he or she has seen and then come to a consensus that that is a favorite movie, right? Instead of that, if you are giving some of the suggestion, by viewing the suggestion, the user can be able to pick the movie faster so that the user's memory is not wasted, right? The next thing that you can do is you can establish meaningful defaults. Now you can see that this is just a registration form, and majority of the things are in text boxes, but you can see that there is a date picker, and in date picker there is a default date that is attached, right? You can put such kinds of defaults wherever it is possible so that the user does not have to, you know, think what I have to enter. If you put a text box in this date, what will happen? The user will be getting confused that what sort of format I have to enter for date, right? So that is not recommended for date. So instead you can put a date picker, you can put a date default, and you have to make this user interface such that they can change the properties of that particular user interface component. So for example, I can pick a date, I can change a date, that all mechanism or interaction should be possible, right? So that is, you have to establish meaningful defaults. The next thing is you can define the shortcuts that are intuitive. It means here you can see that for copy, paste, cut. So the normal shortcuts that are very much predefined over here are Control C, Control V and Control X. So this is a shortcut which are very intuitive and which all the users are aware of. You can put such shortcuts in your web application also, right? Yes, the next is you can put such graphical or you can say images which are very much handy, right? So here you can see I have written match the column. It means the user can know that what is the symbol for battery, what is the symbol for cloud, what is the symbol for user, and what is the symbol for photos. The user can just interact with the symbols and they can perform the task that is required, right? So this will be easier. Okay, so the next point is that the visual layout of the interface should be based on a real world metaphor, because the users will be much aware about the real world things that they are already interacting. You may take that metaphor as a reference and use it in your real world, use it in your user interface of web application, because the real world metaphor enables the user to rely on well understood visual cues rather than memorizing all the, you know, arcane interacting sequences. So that is a better methodology, and that will reduce the load on users' memory, right? Now the next is you have to disclose information in a progressive way or a progressive fashion. So for example, if you have a text box in which he or she has to enter the name of the apartment, then you can do that. You can ask something after he or she is entering into the text box. So that is a progressive fashion, as you can see in an example. Instead of that, many times what you do, you have all the, you can say, questions at once, right? So that is not recommended. It is recommended that you have to disclose the information in a progressive manner so that your web application or your web page does not look cluttered. Okay, and user may not get confused by seeing all these web components, right? The next, you can say the golden rule, or the third golden rule, is maintain consistency in your user interface. It is very important that user, whenever he is interacting with your web application, he or she must not get confused. For example, in one page you are using red color for a button, and in another page you are using a green color for the same sort of button. Then is this a consistent user interface for a same application? I will be thinking that once I am navigating from one page to another, I am in some different website. That is not recommended. So you have to maintain consistency in UI. Here you can see that all the buttons are different, right? So the add, that is create button, move button and delete button, they are different in shape, but they are same in color. That is not recommended. Instead of this, you can see over here the shape of create, move and delete is equal, as well as the color is equal. So this is known as consistency in the user interface components. The next consistency that you have to maintain is in the symbols. For example, here you can see the mail, right? this is the mail that you see in the inbox, and that is the mail that you see in the menu. You can see the symbols as well as the color combination of the button is exactly the same, so that user gets an idea that what is social, promotion, update, right? So that means that if you are in an application and if there are symbols which are used redundantly, then that symbol should be similar. Okay, and the next thing that you have to maintain is, if for example you have different applications, right? If you have, like, for example, Microsoft Word, Microsoft Excel, Microsoft PowerPoint, these are the three different applications, but still the UI of the similar functionality is same because it is from the same vendor. So if you are developing different web applications, then the consistency of the functionality symbol should be similar, right? So that is, you have to maintain user interface consistency. The next topic is user interface analysis and design models. Now, whenever you are in the user interface design part, you have to develop some models. Let us see what are the models that you have to develop. The first model is user profile model. Now, what do you mean by user profile model, and who establishes or who actually creates it? Okay, so the software engineer basically establishes a user profile model. What do you mean by user profile model? It means that you are analyzing that your particular application will be used by whom, right? So based on what factors are we deciding the user profile? The first factor is age, right? Because for example, if you are developing a website for children, the user interface for children will not be subtle, it will be flashy with lots of colors. Instead of that, if you are developing a website that is professional, you have to develop it elegant and subtle, right? So you have to first of all check that what are the target users' age. The next is based on gender. Based on female and male, the preferences of user interface, the preferences of the aesthetic that the gender wants is different. So if your majority of the target is female, you have to develop your user interface a little bit girly or according to that targeted user, right? The next thing is physical ability. There are number of people who are color blind, who may not, who are totally blind, who are not able to use mouse or keyboard very correctly, right? So there are number of people who are physically disabled. If your targeted users consist of physically disabled person, you have to develop your user interface in such a way that they may be able to use your user interface, right? The next is culture. We know that there are myriad of culture, and there are certain rules and regulations in each culture, right? So there is something that is prohibited in one culture which is not in another culture. So whenever you are designing the content of your user interface for different culture, you have to take this into consideration, what is your targeted culture, right? And the last thing that you may analyze for your user profile is education, because if your targeted user are not well educated, then you don't have to put so many web components which are very complex and not easy to use. Instead of that, you can put simpler components, you can take reference from the real world metaphor, and you can put such components through which the user can directly interact, instead of putting lots of text boxes which the uneducated people cannot write, right? So that is, you have to first develop a user profile based on these factors, and you have to develop your user interface components accordingly. The next profile for the design model of interface is design model. Now this is also established by a software engineer, and your design model is basically developed after you have requirements and the needs of your customer. So basically you must have software requirement specification that you have already developed in the requirement analysis phase, and after you have this document, you will be able to develop your design model, right? Now in design model, what does actually design model incorporate? The first thing that design model incorporate is all the data, right? So if it is user interface, all the data, it means all the content that you will put on your user interface, all the content objects that you are going to display, right? Also all the database that will be included, the data structures that will be included in your business logic, that is to be taken into consideration. The next is architecture. You have to develop the overall architecture of your design, right? After architecture, you have to see that what are the interfaces that should be taken into consideration. So where is the boundary of my system and when will I interact with the external system? So that is the interface. You have to take into consideration all the interfaces and you have to analyze and incorporate it in your design model. And the last thing that you will incorporate in your design model is your components or your procedures. That is the actual logic that you will apply. So the algorithms that you will apply, all the database queries that you will apply, that you have to incorporate in your design model, right? Now, after design model, what is the next model? The next model is implementation model. And what does implementation model consist of? The first thing that implementation model consists is look and feel. You have already decided that how your user interface will work, but implementation model sees the overall look and feel of your web application, because it is possible that the individual web components or the individual user interface components are looking good, but when you accumulate them into your page at once, they are not looking good. So that consists of your look and feel, that how are they interacting with each other and is the user comfortable using them, right? So that is the first thing that you will incorporate, that is look and feel. The next things that you will incorporate in user interface, in implementation model of user interface, is the help. We know that there are some users which are not aware about how to use your application. So you must have web documents, or you can say reference documents, that are help documents. Like here you can see the Internet Explorer help document. Also, along with the soft copy, you may have user manuals that are in hard copy, or you may have your all documents of design document, test documents in your implementation model, right? And the last model is user's mental model. Now, what do you mean by user's mental model? We have decided what our user interface will look like. We have already decided what is your all types of model, including your user profile model, design model, as well as implementation model. Now, the last model is user's mental model, in which you have to think what the user will see. Okay, so you have to actually take into consideration the user's perspective. You yourself has to empathize with the user and be a user, use your application, and that is known as user's mental model, so that all the changes that comes from the user's perspective can be accommodated before your application is actually deployed to the user, right? So that is the last model. You yourself have to become a user, use your application, think through the perspective of user, and incorporate all the necessary changes. Okay, so this was all about analysis and design model of user interface and the golden rules of user interface, and this was all about today's lecture. Thank you.